Hello, in this tutorial I will explain how to perform a successful interplanetary orbit in free flight mode. Before launching the spaceship, first you should make sure that you have the right alignment of the planets to perform the orbit. To help you with that, when selecting a planet you will see at the top right of the screen an indication showing the time to the next launch window, and the intended destination for that launch window. In this case we want to perform an orbit to Jupiter, but for that launch window we would have to wait for many days. You can tap the fast forward button at the top right of the screen to accelerate time automatically until the launch window begins. Now is the right time to launch the spaceship. You will notice that the launch window is intended from L2 to Jupiter, so you should spawn the spaceship at L2 to make the orbit easier. This button at the bottom right of the screen can be used to select the different Lagrange points of the planet. Every time you tap the Lagrange button, the camera will cycle through the different Lagrange points associated to the planet. Use it to select L2, and then you can spawn a spaceship at that position. Now you should use the spaceship direction button to select a prograde orbit, and then turn on the engine to start accelerating. In order to have a clear view of your orbit around the Sun, first you have to escape the Earth's gravitational sphere of influence. Accelerating to 2000 meters per second should be enough for that. Zoom out to get a better view of your orbit. Then you have to accelerate again in a prograde direction until your apoapsis matches Jupiter's orbit. To help you with that, you can use the target button to select your destination. In this case, you have to select Jupiter. Then, at the upper right of the screen, you will see the distance to the target at your orbit's apoapsis. You just have to reduce this distance to the minimum in order to make your orbit pass close to Jupiter. Now, your orbit should send you to a close approach to Jupiter. You can use the time slider to accelerate time until you get close to your destination. You can also use the fast forward button to accelerate time until you get to your orbit's apoapsis, or you enter into your target's gravitational sphere of influence. Now you will see that your current speed is too fast relative to Jupiter, so you will have to make some additional corrections until you get into a stable orbit around Jupiter. Now, what if you wanted to make an interstellar travel? In order to do that, first select a suitable starting position, for example L2, and then select a spaceship capable of interstellar travel, for example Project Daedalus. Now tap the target button to select the destination star system. Then tap the spaceship direction button to select inward direction. Once the spaceship is aligned with the destination star system, you can turn on the engines. Unlike interplanetary orbits, interstellar travel requires huge amounts of delta V, so you will have to keep accelerating for a long amount of time. Just make sure you have enough fuel left to decelerate and maneuver when you reach your destination star system. This concludes this tutorial. Check the other tutorials for additional information.